Hi everybody, meteorologist Joe Cioffi. It's weather in five days and 5 minutes, and we're getting the weekend underway. I'm actually down south for the next 10 days or so, and the goatee, by the way, is coming in quite nicely. So let's get going here as far as where we are headed for the weekend, and I think we're headed for a reasonably good place, though it is going to be on the cold side. Certainly today, we are seeing a bit of a warm-up ahead of it from northeast Virginia up into central New Jersey. We'll see temperatures up above 50 in many locations, and then, of course, it cools off a bit as you head up to the north because there is a cold front and an Arctic boundary. So once you get north of New York City, the high temperatures today tail off into the low 40s and even down in the low to mid-30s through upstate New York, where we are going to see some snow accumulate. It's already been snowing there today, and we're going to see a bit more of it before it's all said and done. And when we take a look at some of the snowfall forecasts for this area, north central Pennsylvania coating to an inch, and then you get into about a 1 to 4 inch snowfall in general through upstate New York, and maybe a 1 to 3, 2 to 4 inch snowfall up in New England. But of course, as you head further south from southern New England down to south central and southeastern Pennsylvania, into Maryland and northeastern Virginia, clearly there are no snow issues. So it's all going to be really about temperatures this weekend, and we are going to see them change quite nicely. First, turning colder, that may not be so nice, but then turning warmer. And we're going to do that for Saturday and Sunday will be the cold part, and then Monday and Tuesday will be the warmer part. So highs for tomorrow are going to have a struggle. Probably most temperatures will be in the mid to upper 30s. There might be some 40 degree highs as you head down to South Jersey, down into Northeast Virginia and Maryland. Then on Sunday, we're going to nudge them up into the 40s. Although when you head up to the Hudson Valley, and in Northeast PA and points north, where it takes has a tough time getting out of the 30s. We've got warmer air that's going to start to come in. And of course, with that, we're going to probably have to deal with some rain. Monday and Tuesday are going to be quite mild, though. We'll have a southwest flow ahead of the slow-moving cold front. So we'll be up in the middle and upper 50s on Monday, and we'll be in the upper 50s to maybe even some lower 60s on Tuesday before this front moves through. And then it turns much colder by next Wednesday. Temperatures in many locations won't be out of the 30s. And there is going to be a cold front that comes through here, and we're going to have to wait to see if there's any kind of wave with that front that causes a problem. On the radar today, you see the area of snow. This is snow in upstate New York that is moving eastward. And there may be a scattered rain or snow shower with the Arctic front as it goes by, or afterwards in the colder air that's behind it. You're seeing a little bit of snow shower activity back through northwestern Pennsylvania and into Ohio. This is rain that's in Kentucky and Tennessee, and some heavy downpours and a few thunderstorms back through Mississippi. That's moving eastward, and that will impact the southeastern states today as this weather system moves on through. So let's take you through the next 5 days on the weather models and show you what's happening. So first off, here's our Arctic front for today that goes through with, again, a shower or flurry for most places. Actually, for most places from southern New England down to northeast Virginia, it's going to be a rain shower. You see where the snow area is in upstate New York, and it actually weakens as it moves eastward. So we got this nice cold high that builds in for Saturday. We start the warm up on Sunday as the winds behind it go southwest. And that's going to also open up a moisture flow from the Atlantic and from the Gulf of Mexico. So we're going to start to see showers develop in the mid-Atlantic states and in parts of the mid-Atlantic states and into the Northeast Sunday night and into Monday morning. There's a surge here along the coast. Another surge develops out to the west Monday morning in the Ohio Valley, and that moves eastward into Monday afternoon and evening. That goes by, and then finally the third surge moves through, and that's for Monday night and Tuesday. Now, what's going to happen here is that the frontal boundary is going to stall out, and there is going to be the attempt of one last wave, and that's why you see this little area of snow on the GFS back through western Tennessee and northwest Mississippi here on Tuesday. Now, whether that's real or not at this point, I don't know, because that is 4+ days ahead into the future. But the important takeaway here is that there is going to be one last wave that comes through as the colder air arrives, and that could mean rain Tuesday night that perhaps changes to snow before it ends early Wednesday morning and it's done. Let me just explain that in cases like this, 9 times out of 10, the rain just shuts off and we don't see anything behind it. And usually in the case where it does change over, it's nothing substantial. So we'll watch and see what happens. In the meantime, after that front goes by, much colder air comes in for the second half of next week. And we'll have to see if there's going to be anything of consequence next weekend, as some models have been telegraphing that in the long range. All right, folks, that wraps it up for your Friday Weather in 5. Thanks for being here. I'm going to attempt a live stream tonight, either at 6 o'clock Eastern or 7 o'clock Eastern time. So watch out for that and look for a few more posts peppered along the way as just a little bit of downtime for me. And I needed it after a long stretch of that that snowstorm. So we'll settle down and get everything up to date. And it's over the weekend, by the way, let me just remind you, Sunday morning, we have our Sunday morning weather show, Coffee with Cioffi, on my YouTube channel. We are going to usually do it at 10 o'clock in the morning. We are going to do it at 9:30 Eastern time. So just bear that in mind. All right. Have a great day. We'll see you later.